Hi, Mr. Finley. You're having your operation tomorrow. You're having a TURP, right?
Is that what it's called? It's my prostate. I've been having a lot of trouble with my waterworks.
You mean, when you pass urine?
Well, it's a lot of things. I have trouble getting started, you know?
Trouble starting to urinate?
Yes. I sort of start and stop. It's very frustrating. I feel like I have to pass urine a lot too.
I see. Your enlarged prostate is putting pressure on the neck of your bladder. After the operation, you should find this will improve. And you won't need to strain to pass urine.
Can you explain what will happen during the operation?
The operation is performed through a special tube called a resectoscope. It has a camera and a wire loop which is used to cut away parts of your prostate.
So there is no cutting involved?
Not with this type of prostatectomy.
That's good.
When you come back to the ward from your operation, you'll have a catheter in place. It will stay in place for a couple of days, because your urethra will be swollen. And it will be difficult to pass urine at first.
Okay.
We'll attach continuous irrigation to the catheter at first. The fluid helps to prevent clots from forming.
How long do I have that for?
It's usually for the first 2 days. Your urine will be slightly bloodstained for a few weeks, but that's nothing to be concerned about.
Okay.
It's also normal to have some difficulties passing urine for the first few weeks. It shouldn't be a problem after that. But if you do find you can't pass urine, make sure you tell your doctor straight away.
Is it dangerous?
It can be. If it happens suddenly, and you can't empty your bladder, urine builds up in the bladder, and causes a lot of abdominal pain.
All right. I'll keep an eye out for that. Is there anything else I have to do after the operation?
After your operation, you'll have to avoid lifting heavy objects and doing strenuous exercise for a few weeks. You may also need to take some time off work.
Yes, I've taken a month off. My work is very physical. I have to move a lot of boxes around. The doctor mentioned that I might need to take a break.
Another thing to be aware of is that you won't be able to drive for a few weeks until you fully recover and can drive a car safely.
That won't be a problem. My partner said she'll drive me.
That's good. Finally, try to take it easy for a while. It's quite usual to feel tired for the first few weeks. There's nothing to worry about, as most men are back on their feet in a couple of months.
Okay. I'll try to relax, but I'm really not very good at it.